Hi everybody, welcome to another Quick Wing Tips. Today I want to talk about probably a thing that not a lot of people understand. This is about DAW recording, and especially this is about signal processing. A lot of people want to use their wing for signal processing because maybe they don't have as powerful as a laptop, or they just want to use what they bought. I mean, if you buy this console, you bought a lot of DSP. There is a lot of DSP under the hood of this thing. If you want to use that signal processing, there is a couple workaround, because this console was designed for live sound in mind. You can do some studio recording on it. You can do some really good processing with it for studio recording. And this is what I want to dive into today. The key thing that we're gonna use is user signal. If you go into routing and click on source, here if you click user signal, you have 24 user signals. The user signal can be sent out to USB and can be sources from channel strip and buses. So you can use all the processing on those strip and on those buses and sending out to USB. You can also insert the console. I'm gonna show you that in a couple minutes, but first I want you to understand the basic of how user signal is working. After that, we're gonna dive into my idea of insert mode using the 24 user signal, but stick around, please. A couple video ago, I've used user signal 1 and assigned channel 1 into it. I assigned it pre and we're gonna assign it here in post. Right now, everything that I'm doing here is gonna be sent out to my user signal, and then I can assign my user signal to my USB output. The fact that you can use the user signal, send it into your USB that will send it into your computer, allow you to use all the processing that you have on 24 channel or 24 combination of channel and buses. You could use a channel sending it into a bus and sending that bus out to USB. You can use all that processing of 24 track or 24 different mono sources and apply it to what you record and you send out to your interface. So once you get that, you can also think about another way, another non-destructive way. Why I call this method destructive is because whatever you do on your channel strip is gonna be printed into your DAW. So if you EQ it wrong, or if you apply too much compression or too much gating, you're stuck with that. This is why it would be considered destructive, because it will apply stuff to the audio signal and you cannot change it anymore. Another non-destructive way to use the user signal and the USB to create insert point. Most of you who never work in the analog world of sound patching in compressor and EQ and outboard gear into channel strip probably are not that familiar with what an insert is. Maybe guitar player out there, you call them send and return. And an insert point on a console is just basically a send and a return. So what we can do now with the user signal in the USB out is create a send and return point in the console and in your DAW. Most of them have what we call an insert point plugin. So in Reaper and Logic, I know it's there. I'm pretty sure, I know it's there too in Pro Tool. So I'm gonna guess most DAW nowadays have them. Inside your DAW, those insert points were created to use analog gear. So use the in and out of your interface to insert a real old compressor or analog gear that you physically have in your studio, but we can use the wing like if it was a piece of analog gear and send signal into it and out. So our output is our user signal that we sent out into the USB, but our input can be USB. If we change it here, USB, and select all our input to be USB. If you set an insert in your DAW and you send the signal out with that plugin out to the console, so USB output of your DAW into USB input of your console, and send it back through a user signal into your DAW with an insert plugin. You just created a non-destructive way to use your channel strip in real time inside the session of your DAW. You are inserting 24 mono sources inside your project, your DAW project. And this is non-destructive because you didn't print the track with whatever you're doing there, so you can change everything all the time. On a follow-up episode, I will show you guys how to do it with different DAW, so Reaper, Logic, I still need to do Cubase. Don't worry, it will eventually happen. So that's it for now. If you liked that video, give it a thumbs up. If you are not yet subscribed to the channel and you want to see more stuff about the Wing or live sound or my vlog, there we go, shameless plug for my vlog. Subscribe to the channel. Until the next one, please take care of yourself, and I'll see you guys later.